decided to start with the last project I made, which is Plus Si Entente. Plus Si Entente is a sentence you can find on some kind of website or announce. Sorry for my English, sometimes it's a little bit poor if you don't understand. Me too. Plus Si Entente is an expression to say more if we see that it match.
And maybe more.
And maybe more, yeah, it means and maybe more. So it means we just take contact if we see something nice, maybe we can go further. And of course, it's a very classical expression that we can see when we are in research of a man or a woman. And we go on the internet, create a profile, true or not, and trying to find someone. So a few years ago, I was in Sweden in a festival, and I met Kai Pfeiffer for the second time. Kai Pfeiffer, you can see on this cover, and it's quite funny because when I met him, I also met Uli on the same time. Uli is also a comics author, and she is a very good author, one of the best, in my opinion. But she is also a Kai partner, so funny to see.
Yes. Uli.
So maybe I can continue about another subject than Uli. Well, I met Kai Pfeiffer, and we just talk a little bit and exchange our sketchbook, and I was really in shock because his drawing was so impressive. And we had the idea to start maybe a collaboration or a game or I don't know what, something around creation. And I asked him to propose me a kind of battle and to provoke me. And he did. So he did. And a few times after, some months after, we were in Brussels for the first time, and we decided to start the work. And I will show first something else. He provoked me. I think I'm not in a good I'm not in a good sense of the PDF. I'm sorry. Oh, okay, start again. Sorry. You see all my program in advance. Yeah. Very good and very surprising.
You can go.
Close your eyes, please. That's the provocation. In fact, he proposed me to work on a kind of a game. The idea was a thematic. The thematic was love on internet website, and the rules was we will work on page A4 divided in four panels, and all page will have this layout. And we will produce some images on this thematic. And at the moment we finish a page, we send it to each other. The four panels doesn't have to be a sequence, just images. It can follow each other or not, but it must be on this thematic. So when I received this first drawing and thematic, I was thinking, wow, this is a real provocation. Because to be honest, I'm not at all, I don't have the habit to work on around the idea of erotism or sexuality and so on. I'm very pudic. And generally, till now, I try to avoid this kind of subject because I think it's a very difficult subject which needs a big distance. I would like to make a book about thematic of sexuality. It's a secret, but we are between friends, so you will be the first people to know that. A project that I would like to publish at 70 years old. So I have a big program in my artistic life, and I know already what will happen in the 20 years coming. This project will be around a kind of panorama of women sexuality, mine. And what I would like to do, why 70 years old? Because I would like to make something around the axis of 40 years old, 30 years after, 30 years before, and create a kind of a big, je sais pas comment dire, un éventail, a big 180 degrees. Of what happened in what could happen in a woman's sexuality in life, and in my opinion, my first souvenir were around 10, when something start to be, and also my idea was how to. Is it possible to define if the fantasy will be the same at 70 or 40 than it will than it was at 20, or if the fantasy totally changed because of the evolution of the mentality? This is something which interests me, but also what I would like to do, because as a comics author, I always think a lot about, since the beginning of my work, about the difference between autobiography and fiction, and it's a problem that I like to think about. And especially in that book, I would like to mix some fantasies with some real stories, but never precise if it's true stories or false. And also, I like something I think very interesting is the fact that everything, of course, will be autobiographical, even my fantasies, because it's my projection. But in the part that I will invent, it's possible that I will take the shape of maybe a man or an animal or maybe a little girl or a black man or a Chinese, I don't know, or a walker. And it's interesting to work as an autobiography through the some other character, well, end of the story of the big panorama, come back to Plessy Entente. So here the little text is I'm searching a friend to go out, and friendship age without importance, and more if it clicked, more if
maybe more.
Voilà. Voilà. So can I send me the five first page? You saw the first one, and it was so shocking. I was so that I immediately accept, because to me it was a real a challenge, and also the idea was fun. What I forgot to precise about the rules, it was also the idea of start the process of a comics by playing to inverse the normal process, because of course normally when you start a new comics you write a story, then you make a storyboard, and then you start with the drawings. But here we wanted to inverse the process by starting by producing images, drawings about a thematic, and the idea was at the moment we will have 100 pages, we will recut everything, not with scissors, with Photoshop, and we will put all images on the table and see if it's possible to build a narration based on this image bank. But of course, when we arrived at 100 pages, we in fact had a kind of skeletons already, because we react on the drawing, so some characters were born by themselves, some patterns, and a place. The place was this place. And this place was a house we saw at the first residence we made together, because generally we just work at distance. He is based on in Berlin and I'm in Brussels. So generally we just exchange by internet. But we also sometimes, time to time, we made some residence just for the pleasure to work together, and sometimes to work immediately on the drawing of each of us. Voilà. So during this first residence, it was in Brussels, nearby the airport, and it's a Flemish area. We can say very, very banal. All houses are quite similar. Three window. You don't see the third one, but there is one back to the bush. And in the three windows, you have vases. In all houses, it's like that. Three window, three vases. Often Chinese vases, but not always. And a little garden like that. And when we walked this time, we passed over this house and wow, we saw this wonderful cock. bush cock.
It's a tree, yes.
It's a tree, of course. It's a simple tree. But we were, fascinated by this wonderful tree. And we immediately imagine the nice lady opening window when someone ring.
Yes.
Just And we decide immediately it will be the place where everything happened. And the funny thing was that we made several work, and one day we saw the owners of the house, mm-hmm. and we wanted to know if it's a person with a big sense of humor or maybe some naive person who just wants to cut his bush as a mushroom. But I think the second option is clearly the one, because the people were a very old couple of Flemish person, very, very, seems classical, but we never know, of course, maybe very old people, very rock and roll, all that's possible, but bon, I have doubt. Come back to the drawings, voilà. We started, voilà. And you saw the first page Kay sent to me, in fact he sent five. And when we made this first residence, I made, normally we never say who made what, but for the first pages, and because you are my friend and we are in a very intimate situation, I can say you everything. Everything for you special, my friend. So, this page was the first page I made. And I can really confess you that I was totally stressful, because drawing just next to Kai Pfeiffer was for me a big stress. Generally, I don't like to draw with people, because I don't know, I'm always kind of blocked. We say that. Mm-hmm. It's difficult for me to relax, but after a while it's better, but I need several days. So if you have time to stay with me several days, maybe we can work together. So I made this page. Of course you don't see very well, but normally under this gray part it was a dog head with teeth open, and he was barking. Bon, bref, I made this, I was not really, really satisfied, but okay, I made this. And then I gave it to Kai, and Kai played with all pattern by reinverse or interpreted the proposition I made, and then you can find all frame, but with a kind of déclinaison, on dit ça, comment on dit ça, une déclinaison?
Non,
on ne sait pas.
Variation.
Variation, yes. Exactly like you can have in music, for instance, with, Goldberg variation. You have a sentence, and around this sentence you can start to play and make it more and more far or close, but each new sentence take a new form. That was our process and dynamic. So you see well this page, the next one, this one, is again a new variation on the this, look at this, and what this boxer slip became, a very simple, abstract pattern. So, as you can see, it was the opportunity to play with this thematic and drawings without any limit, in a way of, you can find in poesy.
It's like improvisation.
Wait,
a little bit?
Improvisation, but more. C'est plutôt avoir vraiment comme une.
Ubapien.
Oui, un peu un truc ubapien. Maybe you can just make the
just have this ubapo.
You can just precise for the people who doesn't know ubapo what it is.
Yeah, it's English. Yeah, ubapo is the ouvre de la bande dessinée potentielle. Ubapo. Which is the comics version of ulipo, which is basically coming up with interesting constraints and systems like this to generate comics working within or against constraints.
So, very thank you for participation.
You
don't hesitate. So, and after this, this one, you have also. Voilà. So, it's a game. And I think it's a very nice way to reimagine what we could make with the idea of comics, because is it or not for you a sequence? What is your feeling when you see this? Do you consider this as comics, or to you it's a little bit too far, or I don't know what is your feeling in general?
Yes.
Yes, as in?
Yes, it's comics.
It's comics.
Yes, and when I read the sample, I was very convinced that it would be
so. It was, in fact, quite funny, because even if we decided to work almost blindly due to the narration, because we didn't know which kind of story we will be, just producing these images and make this game. In fact, I can say that very rapidly we had the context. On dit ça? Context? Because what is a context in comics? The context in comics, maybe in movie also, is the character, a situation, global situation, and a place. And then you have some patterns which could be the character, second character or third character. Not the more important, you know. And here, our second character, so we have the main character was a woman, 50 years old, searching men on internet website. And the third or second and third character was lobster. And big bush, cock bush. And we decided that the cock bush will be a kind of, comment dit ça encore, witness. The witness of the sea. He will see everything, and he will be capable to speak a little bit about what's happened in that house, and in the garden, and in the house. He can speak about, he can tell you the truth. Voilà. And then everything can become a pattern that we can explore. So, où habitez-vous? Where do you live? The bush, the house, and the girl. So we had our character, it's this woman, 50 years old, and also husband, you saw in the, voilà. Here, on the first pages, we had already the character, policeman, who is the husband of this woman, Agent Love, called Agent Love. The woman, the girl with a swimming suit. And then continue the process. I will show you a few examples of what we did. Always around the same... this is the only page, because when we have a rules, we always must break the rules. So there is one page without any friends. We decide also to inscribe ourselves, Kai and I, on some internet website for meeting love. And we chose two different websites. The first one was a very classical one for a good family and good couple, very reasonable and good people. The road is straight and everything is good. And we try to see which expression and tendency was the most for the woman, but also for the man. And we inscribe ourselves in another website, very, very creative, called mignon.com. It means cute.com. This website is more rock and roll, hein, funny. Probably used by maybe 95% of male. So there is a lot of men who are looking for a cute girl in that website for a cute moment. Very olé olé. And the expression that we could see the most in the cute website was in French, I don't know the translation, but you can help me. C'est sans prise de tête.
Mm. No stress.
Hein?
No stress.
Oui, mais literally, how can I translate it?
Sans prise de tête.
Si tu le disais littéralement. Sans prise de tête.
Yeah, without...
Sans se prendre la tête.
Yeah.
Sans prendre la tête.
No head without tearing your hair out. Yeah.
Non, mais vraiment, littéralement. Without taking head.
Yeah.
If I make a translate, but it means if I meet you and we have a nice, cute moment, don't ask me if I'm married or if we meet again tomorrow, because.
No stress,
no questions.
No strings.
No strings.
So, and this website was an incredible source of inspiration for us, of concrete poetry. And we took a lot of examples from this website. And of course, we also made a kind of bank of nice profiles and sentences. And there are some men who clearly write a little bit too quickly the profile. And sometimes it gives a very nice result. And an example it was a man. Antillais, comme on dit.
And from the Antilles.
Well, I'm a young young guy from Antilles. On the Azores, it's an island.
No,
he can come from everywhere. But, voilà, it was in the text this. So I'm a young guy, 27 years, a very handsome man, beautiful and so on, searching for a woman without a head. Because he forgot the name without taking head. So he was looking for this woman without head. And it's so true and it's so honest, because why do we need a head of a woman? We just need the rest of the other part. The head is boring anyway.
But how would they read the message if they don't have a head?
Voilà, always without prise de tête. If we take head, we take also prise de tête. So better without. I'm going just maybe to translate here. Voilà, je crois que c'est this or several small annonces.
Can I ask something?
Oh yes, of course.
What was your intention with this process? Was it were you exploring? Or what were you after?
At least we wanted to create a story, but by accepting what the drawings suggest to us. Mm-hmm. The idea was to create a story, but not like we make usually, not by writing a text, a story and so on. But see if it's possible to be open-minded and just welcome the suggestion of the drawing. Mm. Voilà. Alors, the first one, offline, age 46. Ah oui, c'est celui-là. Single, searching a woman for love. I'm mature.
Bottom left. À gauche.
La gauche.
Ah, mm-hmm. Voilà. I'm mature, calm, but with character. I like to relax the ladies. I'm interested in all kinds of women because each one has her own beauty. If you'd like to talk to me, come. I'm very sociable. Alors, case 4, bonhomme. Bonhomme is a little bonhomme. You know bonhomme, bonhomme? Is it an English name, bonhomme? Bonhomme, hein? Non. Bonhomme, comment est-ce qu'on pourrait traduire ça?
A guy.
A guy, but it's more
a fellow.
Childy word. And a bonhomme generally is used for a man very kind, but probably a little bit naive, round, cute, probably also. Bon. Bonhomme is the smallest bonhomme. 375 bonhomme lives in Liège, searching a woman for whatever. Male, 40 years old, who loves the pleasure of life, is hoping for beautiful encounters without taboos. Three rules: hygiene, discretion, and respect. Keys. This page, age 54, Flemish Brabant. I'm quite shy. I like the countryside and children. Favorite meal, spring rolls. Case 3. I don't like. This is the man who presents himself by what he doesn't like. So don't bother him. To cross your path if you are too young, or if you don't correspond to my taste and to what I wish. Okay. Very pleasant guy. Probably the one I want to contact. I like difficulties. So, this page, as I said, is in the middle of the book, and it's a page we made to because it's a little bit like a resume. Mm-hmm. C'est le résumé. It's the strong moment of the book. When we arrive at 100 pages, as I said, in fact, we had already our skeletons.
A summary, sorry. A summary.
A summary?
Yeah, a resume.
The story, this woman, 50 years old, searching man, and in fact, we will decide to try to show what she will project as a fantasy with all these men she will cross on the internet. And what she will dream on, she will dream to invite all the men together at the same time, the same moment, the same place, her garden and her house. And she will become the queen of this small world for her pleasure, and the book will show her world. So, welcome in the mother, the name of this woman, the mother. This is her paradise. Paradise full of men crying by waiting for her. Crying not because they're sad, but because they're very full of emotion and too much in love, too much ready for sex and desire, and you see they are happy, playing, but where is the mother? Of course, she plays with desire and she doesn't go very often in the garden because men must wait, cry, and being full of desire. If you go too much, they will be they will stop being so much ready. And why all these vases? Because of the window that I spoke about. And also, these vases become also a pattern, and we decided that the mother ask the man not coming, please, with flowers. I hate this because flower make her think about age. When flower become too quickly,
flowers will.
Well. So she ask not flowers but vases, because vases she can collect it, always beautiful, and also the vases could be a nice symbol of maybe women body, women interior, or the c'est la partie qui contient et non pas qui... C'est pas le contenu, c'est le conteneur, quoi, tu vois.
C'est le container, not what it contains.
But it's like, it looks like hot water bottles to me.
What?
Hot water bottles.
What does it mean?
It's like a comfort. It's a...
It's a very English
nice
perspective, I you think. Have a hot water bottle.
But it's like that thing you have when you're alone in bed, something nice and warm to cuddle.
Interesting.
Yes.
No, it's very interesting, and you will see afterward, but I like this idea. So, when we finished that book, we decided to use this page to try to make a kind of extension of the comics, but especially for exhibitions. And this was the thematic for the exhibition, Le Jardin des Candidats, a candidate garden, which is also a kind of Greek mythology garden or things like that. And again, we decided to play with all the pattern you can find in this garden. So you have male tears, male figure with full of beautiful emotion. Of course, bushes, holes, vases, green, this green color. And we decided to put ourselves some new contraintes, comment on dit rules or comment?
Constraints.
Constraint. The first one was the color. We decided to make all the drawings of the exhibition in green only. It can be all kind of greens, but green. Why green? It comes from a very stupid part of my personality because I'm a little bit je suis un peu contrariante, quoi, tu vois.
Contrary.
Oui. Because of what? My gallerist in Brussels said me one day, you know, Dom, I hate green color. And if you make some drawings in green, I will never take it. And I said, okay, I will do everything. C'est un peu mon rapport contrariant. Contradict. Voilà. And we decided to start playing with patterns that you can see in the gardens and explore the world of the garden. But also, we used all the little sentences we took on the website, and we made some kind of gallery of portrait of male crying with these sentences. For the exhibition, we decided to work with comment dit ça, les formats, les formes, les formes, with shapes rarely square or rectangle, but more without any forms or polygon or circle or whatever. Again, because we wanted to try to make something else that we usually do. When some comics drawers make exhibition, in general, they exhibit the drawings they make in the book or the same drawing in big or things like that. To us, it's not really interesting. What is interesting for us is to recreate a kind of a variation. Again, the idea of the variation on the sentence, but here it's a variation of the narration. And playing with the space we have to propose to the public a kind of reading, but that you could make a little bit more freely by yourself by going from here to there, and some association. Why I was interested when you spoke about the la bouillotte, là, you see here, it's a pot holder, you know that, in crochet. It's again the idea of hot thing that you must protect yourself before touching. And we could say that in a kind of way, mother is so hot, so burning she's so dangerously hot that we must carefully approach to touch her. Maybe we will not succeed. Too dangerous. So, again, as I said, we just took the pattern. The pot holder, it came as an idea, I even don't know from when or where. I think, because I make crochet, I like crochet and I make this during the winter with my open fire. Oh, it's so beautiful. I'm not at all rock and roll, you see. I'm very, very classical. And one day I wanted to see some model for pot holder, and I see on eBay a woman who presents some kind of thing she made, and she made an arrangement on the wall to present all her pot holder together, and it was so beautiful as an abstract installation. Beautiful, and wow, this is for me. I took it. I took her. I stole it. And we play. So again, like in the book, we made, I can say, maybe 400 drawings. And when we have an exhibition to make, we just come with our big box of million paper and frames and so on. Generally, drawings like that, now we glue it on some piece of wood to make it very flat, but the small part are just on paper. So we come with million drawings, not million, I exaggerate as usual, but a lot, and we put everything on the floor, and then we started to play by just making association. And then we create a kind of narration. This is a little bit different because it's a real drawing. This is very big, it's like 2.750 meters. And we also buy some vases, green of course. Like 30 or 40 vases that I have now in my house, and imagine how it's pleasant to find a place to put my 40 vases in my house.
Why didn't you make them?
Sorry?
Why didn't you make them? Did Pottery make them?
Myself?
Yeah.
Yes, it's not, again, not stupid, because I also start with ceramics for this exhibition. Also because I try all the time with a new project, starting with a technique that I really don't know. And in general, in my artistic life, I try to avoid the techniques I start to know too much, because I don't like to be too comfortable. I always try to keep a part of handicap, because when you are not totally under control with a technique or a tool, you are often you are generally obliged to find some solution that you not immediately think about, but maybe turn around an object to find solution, and it creates more imagination generally when you are not too comfortable. So this is the gallery of crying men in ceramic. And also bushes, which become another kind of quite abstraction. Poor baby.
All these crying men, I can think of Roy Lichtenstein's paintings, which so often had weeping women taken from American romance comics where women were always sobbing. And this is almost like your revenge on...
Sam Taylor Wood, you know the filmmaker, Sam Taylor Wood did, was it Robert Downey Jr.? She did all these films of weeping men.
Oh, yes. Oh.
Sam Taylor Wood at the National Portrait Gallery. Mm-hmm. She did weeping men.
No, I didn't know.
Yeah. Cool. Can't find it for you.
But real men don't cry.
Yeah.
when was it?
I'm going to find all the stuff. I thought it was... Because David Beckham was asleep. Do you remember? She did a whole series.
Oh, yeah. She
David Beckham was asleep. Mm. And
so now it's contemporary.
Yeah.
Well, here, for example, we wanted to replay. This is something I like very much because it shows very well how I interact and play with the two worlds I prefer, the world for exhibition and books. But the bridge between the two is narration. And when I make comics, I try to take the codes outside of comic to create a comic. But if I make an exhibition with painting, I will try to keep some codes from comics to feed So we played with some balloon for the exhibition. And we also played by replace the word by images. So we had the idea to make, for instance, some pattern almost abstract. They all speak about horse. But if you see even this, a man speaking about a whore by crying, it says a lot about himself, about his emptiness or his feeling of loneliness, or I don't know. It's very easy to give an impression. Even this one, with his little bush, I don't know what he can think about, but voilà. And first of all, we made this balloon without knowing with what it will be connected. So this time, when we were in this exhibition, it was the last one in France, Amiens. We just finished it. And we suddenly had the idea to link the sculptures with drawings by Balloon. Voilà. Voilà, this is some gallery of portraits with the little sentences from the website.
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah, of course.
In the summary page with all the men in the women's garden, I read that when you went to Moscow, that page caused a bit of a problem.
I don't know if I have some images about that. I will quickly try to see. Ouais, voilà. So we made this exhibition, but each time with a total new form, huh, because the exhibition depend of the possibility of the walls. The fact was that one of the exhibition was made in St. Petersburg during a comics festival. We were invited, and they offer to exhibit our work in a Nabokov museum, which is, of course, a big proud for me, because Nabokov, wow, it's one of my big favorite author. And this time, Kai made alone the disposition on the wall. He worked for 2 days because it's a huge work with all these million drawings. But also it was a mural with one model, 1 million of men, and the model is only one, of course. So he painted the mother lying on a huge mountain of books. She's just like that. She's nude, waiting maybe a visit of men, or I don't know. But problem was that during the process of putting everything on the wall, a big man from the museum, maybe a guardian or thing like that, he was sent it by the owner, the boss of the museum, and he came like that in front of Kai, and he said, "This is not no nudity." Bon, the problem was that it was only nudity. What to do? No nudity. What do you mean? No nudity. And the guy said, "It's not possible. We cannot accept nudity in the museum. So you have to hide it."
The museum is the museum of
Nabokov,
the writer.
Yes. Yes.
Who wrote about? He wrote Lolita.
Nabokov quit his country during his life because he had quite a lot of problems with authority.
So he quit his own museum.
And then now there is a museum. And in this museum, we had to hide male nudity. So we were, of course, embarrassed. And they said, you could, for example, they said, add some leaves. So I was
like,
wow,
the tree,
I said, bon, I will think about. Thank you very much for the idea. First of all, we discussed, Kai and I, to know, to see if we want to continue, of course, because. Do we have to change our work because a museum decide nudity is not good? We were not sure. And then I said to Kai, okay, now we are there. Maybe we can play with this as a new rule we have to play with. And I said, okay, we will hide all sex, but we will make more like that, adding some small underwear, but not really well done, sometimes clearly too big, or sometimes by kind of almost abstract, and we made generally fluo. You wanted to say something?
No.
Mm-hmm. Or, as you see in the preview one, by adding some black dot on each penis and ass that you can see.
Now they have another motive to cry. Exactly.
But of course, when the museum responsibles came and see that we just mocked them, you can say that kind of, we just were not mocking about you, we mock about life, or about, they said no, it's not possible, because in fact they want we hide this, but they don't want to be censure responsible. So they don't want, but of course we played with this, we receive a censure, okay, we show that we receive a censure because this is fun for us. And by the way, I accept, I obey so we made the opening, and we think, okay, huh, they will make with what we do. But the day after, they put everything off, and without saying anything, just everything was.
So what did they do? They paint it over?
Had they invited you, right? So presumably they knew your work and they had invited you.
Not totally, because in fact they accept the comics festival, but I think they had the idea that it's more children comics or something like that.
Okay, so it was the comics festival we used in the Nabokov Museum as a venue, so the actual museum administration weren't quite aware of your work. Yeah. And there was a clash between the festival and the museum. And okay, thank you. I couldn't get it.
And voilà. Il y a encore un petit truc que j'ai oublié.
They could have just said over 18s only.
Mm. I mean,
and then it's Russia, you know. And they had a lot of. There were other people having problems with homosexual creatures, and it's getting really wild. And
So, in fact, it was a problem because they thought that we make an apology of homosexuality, which is totally the opposite, because they are all waiting the mother. And the funny thing was that Kai asked, okay, but because the mother was also naked, but we didn't see her sex, we just see her big boobs. And Kai said, do we have to hide the boobs? And we made it by putting some, comment dire encore, des post-it. We put some post-it on the boobs. And they said, no, the woman is not, it's not necessary, because a woman, it's more symbolic. Les femmes, c'est plus symbolique. Naked woman is symbolic. And men is realistic. Okay. Another proposition. And voilà. And normally the text in the balloon, we put each time it's and tonight. Barbecue. Normally, it's the text in the balloon. But this time, we made no skin, no barbecue. Voilà. I think I spoke a lot. I wanted to speak about my three projects, but I think it's already late. Maybe boring. Maybe you sleep. No, you don't sleep too much.
I want to just say one thing. You know, earlier, you were showing the pictures of the men crying, and they were speaking the hole in the ground. Yeah. So I'm sure, you know, in feminist theory about talking about women's bodies and men having, you know, their genitalia, and a woman being the hole and the crack and the absence, and I'm guessing you're thinking about all that too. Mm-hmm. In that, but it's kind of discussed, you know, as the crack and the absence, and so they're talking about the hole, but that's.
Tu veux me traduire? Je suis pas sûre d'avoir compris.
In feminist discussions about how feminist bodies have been, women's bodies have been discussed.
Of course.
Feminist theory talks about, we know women's vaginas and their bodies, and the idea of this crack, this unknown, this depth, and so that. You know, they're crying over nothing, and also they're crying over the discussion of the presence of a woman's body, which is actually quite like a feminist way of discussing women's. Do you see what I'm saying? It's like two sides going.
Two sides.
Yeah.
Maybe you knew that. Yeah. Je ne sais pas. Vous avez des questions peut-être?
Well, let's see. It's about 6:20. Would that be useful to open the floor to questions? Because I'm sure we all want to hear Dominique say a bit more, but maybe we can do that structured around some questions.
And also, you had some questions.
I have about 1,000 questions that I don't want to Dominique.
Really, really.
Well, actually, I have another question about the fact that this exhibition was censored in Russia, because I read something you said afterwards that you didn't understand because the Hermitage Museum is full of naked people, the Fine Art Museum is full of naked people. What do you think is more specific about a drawing of a naked person that upset people?
It's more because our naked male were sometimes in underwear, sometimes naked, sometimes a little bit enthusiastic. But it's only cartoon. But
not symbolic anymore.
No, not symbolic anymore.
It's realistic.
They also don't look very powerful. I do a lot of work in talking about the nude bodies, both male and female, because the thing that I do to survive is that I'm a life model. So, and I know lots of life models, and I know people who have also men model for them. So we talk about this a lot, and it's really interesting how the male body is always supposed to look powerful and in control, and the men in your images, which is one of the things that I really like about the work you've shown, is that they look quite vulnerable, and they show their vulnerability. And they don't seem particularly self-conscious of it. Some of them do, but it's not. You know, they don't look vulnerable and therefore look at them dying gruesomely or something. You know, they look vulnerable and they just are. And they're expectant. And there's a lot of that going on. And somebody said, you know, they're weeping, and we have lots of weeping female imagery, and we don't have that much weeping male imagery, and that's connected to sex and desire. And so you're actually associating the male nude with lots of things that are not normally associated with masculinity. And I think that's possibly why a very conservative institution, what is now unfortunately a very conservative country, got upset about it, and then they verbalized it as, oh, this encourages male homosexuality, because, oh, they have a law around that, so it's really easy for them to shut it down. But I think the reality is more complex than that. It's kind of showing the male nude in a way that it's not like, oh, the powerful male nude, but maybe you'll see the Hermitage Museum and in lots of classical arts. Because, I mean, the discussions that I've had, and recently actually, that I've had about the melody that I was thinking about as I was listening to you looking at your work, are to do with how it's absolutely fine for a nude female to be passive. And the thing is that if you're in the middle of a circle of people and they're drawing you or painting your image and you're naked, you are passive. You're sitting there and you're still. You need somebody to rearrange your heaters for you. You know what I mean? It's a big thing. And nobody has a problem with females looking like that, but some men, when they model, they're absolutely fine with it. And other men, when they model, they have different strategies for dealing with it. Like, some men will deal with life modeling like an extreme sport, and they do these like super grueling poses of seeing men doing poses, just like, don't tell me you can stand for an hour because you're stronger than me. That's not true. You're hurting yourself. But you want to look strong, or they pose with poles and that kind of stuff. And all this stuff is to do with taking the vulnerability out of a man and nude. So when you just don't do all of that, and you just let that normal human vulnerability come through the image of a naked man, that rattles people quite a lot. And I think it rattles people in general, and particularly people like that in that really conservative environment. That seriously freaked them out. I can see why. I think it's that rather than the actual male nudity in itself.
Yeah, probably it's interesting. But I continue on that idea because it's true that one of the things which was a real motor for us in the narration was the idea of ambivalence. We worked on ambivalence. We wanted this woman. Comment dire? She had the behavior of someone who can play with 100 men as a queen, authoritarian, with a powerful. But in fact, in her life, she had. A big trouble because Agent Love is gone. The daughter is like a ghost. We don't know if she's maybe die or just disappear. But in fact, she is in a big loneliness. And the male is exactly what you said. We wanted to play the two opposites has to be together. The strongest feeling with the weakest, and we all the time played with that. How to transmit an idea with tears and fun or joy and sadness together at the same exact moment. Because in fact, it's something in each of us. We are never only the coward person or the courageous one. We are both together. And we can be good and bad at the same time. Because we are good for certain person, bad for others. We can make something beautiful, helpful for someone and ignore the pain of another person 1 hour after. It's more interesting because often in comics characters are so clearly defined. You have the hero who is strong and the bad man who is only coward, and this is so strange for me.
Speak a little bit about pretending as lying and what it was like to, because this is the book probably that a lot of people here are more familiar with because it's been translated into English this year, and I'm just really fascinated about, because you re-lettered every page with the English text. I wonder how much the work changed for you when it was translated into English. If anyone would like, I'll pass it through in case anyone wants to have a look.
I finished this book 10 years before.
Yeah.
Perfect day.
It's a book I work on for a period of 10 years. It doesn't mean that I work 10 years on it, because it's not that that much work. But. It's an autobiography, and I tell mainly my childhood problem with violences, trouble in my family, especially violences that I subit from my mother. But in another way, I also must make the portrait of each of the member in the family. My father, who was unfortunately very dependent of alcohol, and myself, also dependent of alcohol. No. This is now. This book I made I couldn't work on only during the moment my family was a little bit far of me, which was quite easy because my father died during the process, and my mother has the nice habit to break down the relation for often a very long period of several years. So each time she decided to break, I can continue the book, and each time she come back to me, I put my book in the fridge, and it was frozen for a couple of years, and then up I opened again the fridge and started again. In fact, I made a first version. And this version, my big problems was how can we speak about something very, very strong that happened to you, but also to the relatives or people you know. Because you, of course, involve people without asking them authorization, permission. And also my idea was not to make a revenge against my mother or my father. It was only, to me, a big necessity to put all this past in distance through art, thanks to art. And to come back to the last point we speak about ambivalence and so on, the first version I made of this book, I decided to tell the third part, which is the part where I speak about a very cruel punishment that I had in my childhoodness. And I decided to tell it by taking distance, just tell facts. But when I give it to my publisher, after my book was finished, 10 years, it took 10 years, and I give it to Jean-Christophe Menu, and he read it, and he said, it's nice and so on, but I have to say you something about the third part. I didn't feel really a lot. I don't know if you want it like that, but to me, I read it a little bit as I read something about your shopping. I was so disappointed, even angry, to be honest, because 10 years you made this book and then everything is finished and your publisher said this. And he said, I don't know if you made on purpose, but if you don't, you have to know. And I said, of course I made on purpose. What do you believe? What do you want? You want, I make people cry about my victim life. No. I want this distance. And I said, okay, no problem. If it's your really what you want, I publish it like that. But of course, the day after, I think about that and I decide, no, it's not good. So I decided to start again totally the third part, but in a complete new way. I decided to not telling facts, but more to try to explore the link between people at the moment of this fact. And I realized that, in fact, an autobiography, I said to you that it's a very important problem for me, what is an autobiography, especially in comics. To me, an autobiography in comics is, in fact, not really possible. Why? Because everything is subjective. what you choose as moment, what you will put together and make all together, it's not the reality. So it's already a rearrangement of the reality. And by the way, even the facts are inspired by your own way to live this fact. If I would ask my mother to tell exactly the same period, you would have a total different story, of course. So I understood that what I have to speak about is not really the reality, but more the trueness, my trueness. And what was my trueness, and that's why, and that's how I changed totally my book, what was my trueness? My trueness was that even if my mother made this, sometimes this monstrous act on me, despite of that, my mother, I adore her. I was adoring her. It was my big love when I was a child. I really loved my mother. So if I succeed to make you feel an empathy for my mother, despite you read that she make terrible thing to her child, this is a nice challenge, and if I succeed this, my book will be a kind of deliverance for me. And how did I do to tell this trueness? I decided I thought, but why did I love my mother like that? I loved my mother like that, but because she took a lot of time with me when I was a child. We passed a lot of time, and one thing we made together, and it was really fantastic, we played all the time, games, together. A lot of games, Monopoly, chess, enfin, whatever, cart and so on. But there was one game we made all the time. And when I decided, oh, maybe I could put the two together just to provoke a shock between the worst of my mother and the best, I thought, okay, I will draw this terrible punishment. She will stop the punishment and she will propose me a game. Of course, I don't remember if this sequence could exist together. I don't think so. But I decided to put together. And then I realized that it was a game that we played all the time together, but I never thought about the title of this game. What was this title? Ne t'en fais pas, means don't worry. So can you imagine the magic of this moment that I put together? My mother put me in a terrible situation of violence. She stopped the punishment. She proposed me a game. Which game? Don't worry.
War.
And I think this is something more than fact. It's the magic.
I think you could make clear a bit more what the problem was the mother was.
What do you mean?
Yeah, you say that you loved her very much, but people don't understand why you should not love her. It's normal that you love her.
But I said she was very violent. As an example that I tell in the book, she sometimes she could suddenly explode about nothing, and when we were a child, for example, but it was not the only example, but this one was very impressive as an image, she put me in the attic and lock me in the attic, but she considered that maybe it's too fun to be locked in an attic for a child, because in this attic it was some coffers with you know, Christmas thing or a thing like that, and maybe I will take pleasure to touch this. So she, mais je sais pas comment le dire en anglais.
She tied
my hands in the roof, and I had to hang up like that for a while. So this is a level of violence more than slap, because when you slap, it's impulsive. But to do that, you have to take your child in the attic. So it's already a moment you can think. And then you have to ask, okay, put your hand up, because otherwise, if it's like that, you are not capable to make So you need to have the participation of the child who accept to stay like that to help you to make this. Okay, so she was really, really violent. She was as worse as she could be good. This, so ambivalence. Maybe.
Was she ill? Was she ill?
In my opinion, yes. Because it's only one example. I have a million. So today I don't see her anymore. But probably a little bit thanks to the work I make with my book and the distance I took. But I think the love I had for her was in fact linked with the fear. Because I must be totally in empathy with her to receive less danger from her.
But you frame your book, the book is framed by you and your daughter and you and your lover at the end.
Yes.
So that's kind of, if all I had was you as a child experience the trauma, I would be stuck with you. But we have these possibilities.
Yeah. Also, I want, this is something I add in one of the period I stopped the book. Then I come back and I didn't want to continue just as I made. Each time I come back to this book, I totally change the, and one time I decided to add my life in the contemporary situation with a very banal situation, love situation, nothing very deep. It's sad, it was a separation, but it's a total normal situation. And yes, you're right, after I also become myself mother, and Nikita is also present in the book. Maybe I can quickly, in 2 seconds, finish.
But it's not totally, I mean, you make that bit of the lover like it's nothing, because your lover has another gut partner, and it's kind of complicated. And
yeah, faire semblant, c'est mentir. Pretending is lying.
Yeah, so it's not, I mean, she just softened that whole ending. I thought it was quite upsetting. I mean, this, the kind of instability, the domestic instability continues. That's what I'm trying to say.
Yeah, I will say 2 words on this project, because it's a nice way to finish. This is a book I made with my daughter Nikita, because when I became a mother, I was very anxious about the kind of mother I will be and if I will repeat the schema. Also, I was very doubting about the idea of mother instinct, because I really didn't know what it is. I was not sure to be the good mother in love with our child. And when I had my baby, of course I loved her, but it was not a total evidence as some other mother. So I was separate with the father, and I decided to try to respond this question by drawing Nikita. At certain moment, I feel this power of love for her. But in the beginning, it was only a nice drawing of my nice little daughter, and I thought, no, this is not interesting. If I want to speak about the link and the love, I have to think again about my mother love. What was love? Love is time. So if I want to speak about the love in or the relationship with my daughter, I must confront it myself to her, and I must speak about time. So I asked one day when Nikita was 7, hey, it would be nice if one per week I would make your portrait and you would make my portrait. And we will make this for 10 years. Do you agree? She was 7, she said, yes. Super. Of course, for her, it was a total abstraction. 10 years, when she's 7, she can't imagine what kind of period it can be. So this is the first portrait we made of each other. But you will see that very, very rapidly, this is a few weeks after, how it evolved from this to that already. And then we made this for 10 years running. I didn't know if it will work. But my idea was, if it worked, if we succeed to take pleasure, even despite sometimes less feeling or tired, or if we succeed, then we will publish. But if we publish it, we will publish the whole experience. Because, of course, some drawings are less good than others, but I wanted to keep them because the bad drawings speak also about our link. So voilà. Look, has what kind mother she has, Nikita. And of course, the interesting thing, I was wondering where time will be in this project, where time will inscribe. I didn't know if it will be only because the pile, the heaviness of the work, or something like that. But in fact, time, the concept of time, was printing in a total other way for her and for me, because through her drawing, between 7 and 17, you can imagine her style evolved totally from a childhood drawing to adult drawing, but my physical stay approximately the same between my 30 and 40, for example. And through the drawing I made of her, my style evolved, but not that much, but her physical changed totally. So you had a very contrary movement, and in between this parallel movement, you find the time relation. C'est très joli. It was something I didn't preview before. Voilà. That's all.
Does anyone have any questions?
Yeah, I have a question about the translation of your work. I just looked at. And it's quite a practical question, because often, some of the text is very graphically ingrained in the image, and that shows from your other work that you showed us earlier, about the way the text appears on the page is very graphic. So it's actually quite a graphic translation, mm-hmm. as well as a word translation. And I'm wondering how that works in practice, but also how it affects you when you look at your translation.
My publisher cleans all the drawings by Photoshop. Now there is 8D different translation, and it's in the contract. I said for all translation, I made the lettering, because to me, it's one of the most beautiful thing in comics. It's the fact that the drawing is a way to write, because it's telling a story. So it's a kind of reading. So images are a kind of writing a story. And in comics, you can have both level of lecture, reading. For instance, you can have a text who say the little girl was sleeping, and on the image, you see the little girl running the night in the garden. I want to play with this. To me, it's very important. The notion that the image is a kind of text, but also the text is included in the image. So it is image, it is drawing. Even if you write in with computer, you cannot pretend that the text doesn't exist in the images. And to me, it's important to play with that. But it was your question.
Wait, it's really interesting to compare the two.
And also, there is something very important to me. I think if generally people use computer in comics, it's for two main reasons. The first one is it's easier for translation and so on. But the other reason is a comic is a book you read alone, at the opposition of illustration. An illustration book, generally, you read for a child. There is a communication between two persons reading. But a comics, you are in a kind of bubble, and you don't want to be interrupted. Because when you read a comic, it's like you are included in the story. You feel the story a little bit like you see a movie, watch a movie. And as in a movie, everything is made to make you forget it's a movie, so you will never see a light or a part of the camera or a microphone. Everything is well hidden to make you forget it's a movie. So you are in the movie, included somewhere. I think in the comics it's a little bit something like that. The text must be as forgotten. So you read it, but exactly like you hear noise. So it disappears a little bit. When it's handwritten, it's more present. But I like that. And also, I think that it's a little bit petty that people don't use, in my opinion, enough the possibility that the text in drawing give as a noise or a different voice, or like I made in the first part of my book, how it's easy to express alcohol effect by at least lettering, dancing, you know. So it's a huge world. What you can make with this sound if you don't make it disappear.